I think there are several dimensions to globalization. One is very spatial specific. You know, for example, poverty is localized, you know, in certain specific areas. If we talk about environmental destruction, it's also very specific. I think when we talk about a flat world, we're talking about economics, finance, and these types of areas. And I think that we cannot trivialize globalization. And I think the problem that I see today is that a lot of attention is being paid to economics and finance for obvious reasons, but this is not all. You know, the banking crisis is not all. Behind this banking crisis, there is a tremendous poverty crisis, hunger, unemployment, destruction of the family, destruction of local organizations, and so on. There is a human factor that is also universal, but different in different parts of the world, and we need to reach these parts of the world. It's not like all of us think the same way. All of us have the same values. So the world is really not flat. We have flattened the world on certain things, but other things are not flat. There are many things that don't go through the internet. Love and compassion doesn't go through the internet. There are many things that don't go through the telephone lines, through the transport line, which are your feelings, your identity, your capacity to have a cohesive and a stable society, and so on and so forth. So what we are having here is a flat part of the world with many mountains we still need to conquer. So to trivialize globalization as making the whole world flat, to me, is an interesting proposition, an alarming proposition, but I don't think it's true. But I have to recognize, however, that we are living in many ways a world without frontiers, in culture, in music, in many, many different ways. And I think this raises a fundamental issue, that if the world is becoming flatter and flatter all the time, then what is our capacity to live a collective existence? Because we can say the world is flat, but we are making it a chess table only for few people. You know, whether flatness means equality, freedom, empowerment, opportunity, security. And what I see most of the time is that this flatness has created more risk, more insecurity, more uncertainty. Just look at the crisis of today, you know, very flat. Someone here, you know, in the secondary market for mortgages, you know, creates a problem, and then the whole world has pneumonia in the real estate market, in the banking, and so on and so forth. And I think, yes, that is flat, but this raises the question whether we have the organizational structure, whether we have the institutions to manage a flat world. This flat world cannot be free for all world. A flat world cannot be a world with no regulation, no governance structures, no collective institutions. And I think it is right to talk about this flat world because the cars might run faster in a flat surface, but also can crash on the wall in a worst, you know, possible scenario. So coming back to the central is that, yes, we're living in a world that is flat for some things like finance, like money, like technological transfer and so on, but it's not flat in terms of value system, in terms of migration, in terms of culture and so on. And please don't make it flat, because flat in many cases means the destruction of our environment, the elimination of indigenous people, the elimination of cultural values, the elimination of the collective existence.